My basic go-to with standing pass is palm on his hip, that can flow anywhere from the hip bone all the way up to the floating ribs. Okay. My elbow, palm here. Okay. Elbow flares out a little bit against that femur. Okay. And then I push down with my palm. There's all kinds of grips you can get. You can be in the center here, that's perfect, especially for like opening up. You can get kind of mid-calf too if you want to back out and pin. That's also really good. But sometimes I just go to a simple pull, push, kind of no grip at all. That way I can slip inside really easily. I can change the direction of the push. So I can push back, push up to the side or on the inside. So right palm is gonna go on that floating rib, right elbow into the femur. I'm gonna push down here and really trust my weight. Really trust my weight. I want you guys, so you can get into this, like trusting your weight and getting out of range of his hooks. This is deadly. I mean, you gotta do all this stuff to like skirt those hooks. I want you in here, trusting, even if he's reaching for my legs, I want the legs, your legs, out of range, okay? Boom, let's drop that front knee and then drop the shoulder on top. Then we can come back. Walk, walk, trust that angle. Look at those active toes. Drop the front knee. Then drop the shoulder and push it past. So the palm is doing so many things. Palm is weight distribution. Elbow is blocking. Palm pushes down. Drop the front knee. The push down goes to a push past. And drop your shoulder inside, okay? Let's warm up. One, two, three. I want to hammer out just a couple more details about passing like this. Okay, number one, your elbow can be up here. You know, if he skirts it on the inside and slips under, well, you can play that game, push up and down. I can put my elbow at the top of the femur. I can also put my elbow at the bottom of the femur. I don't even have to have the hand. I can be like this. I kind of had a breakthrough a little while ago where it's really about, you can put the weight on the palm of the elbow, or just the elbow. Totally good. So Lucas Lepre does quite a bit of weight distribution into that elbow. So now we're going to go, we are going to go around, and he's just clammed up. His knees are in, okay? So I can get around, because his knees don't have the reach, I can get around pretty well. And now I'm gonna go parallel with my femur and his femur. And what I do is I just roll my knee back and open that up, okay? So I'm here, it's all clammed up. We've all faced this guy where it's just like, okay, you wanna be the clamp, that's fine. So get your knee here, I'm still weight on him, okay? I can put my palms on the shoulder and ribs, and then I open, and open that up, and then just take that place. So many people know how to pass, but then they don't know how to block, right? So you gotta get that block in there. So just get yours. If you can't get it in like this, go parallel, and then roll it open, okay? Let's do a little bit of that shin work, okay? One, two, three. I want to talk about, you know, certain body parts hook around other body parts very nicely. They fit well. And so I want to talk about the shoulder head region, especially when it comes to these guard passes where we, let's go here. You know, we're coming around. I'm going to drop that knee, and you can put the shoulder here, but I feel that getting my shoulder right in his hip and then my head on the other side, there's like a little nook right there. Here, let me do it again. So rather than being up here with my shoulder, I actually, and there's space here, I want to be low, head in this nook. This is your friend, right? This is the halfway, this is a dividing line, the halfway point, okay, with the bod. So we don't need to go all the way, we just need to be able to go halfway. And then we can hold, then we can regather, and then we can secure up top, right? So We're gonna go back to dropping that front knee. We're gonna go back to dropping the front knee, because we're kind. And there's more control. I drop my shoulder in here, okay? And then I want you to back step a little bit and get comfortable with that back step. Because sometimes you gotta do that. Sometimes you gotta do that back step in order to clear his legs. Okay. And of course, you know the one where you flip over, like you're in the guard, butterfly guard, and you flip over. That I'll show you real quick. And I'm really not going into Chris that hard. You know, we come over here. And that also is an incredibly useful preventative tool for the choke. Actually, Helsin showed me. I'm inside your clothes guard.
Oh.
And he's got a choke, or at least a one hand for the choke. He's got one hand deep. I'm worried. What am I doing? I'm going to bury my head right here. He has access to one side of my head. I'm not going to give him access to the other side. So I'm going to take away one side. I bury it here. And then we work out, take our time, you know, block. Most people get bored when you block them. They do something else. Okay, so let's really notch our head. This is important. Head over here, shoulder over here with the hip. We're coming around, drop that front knee, okay? And then you can back step too a little bit. Come back into position, okay? Let's find that nook for our neck. One, two, three. Real small details and others are not. Okay, so let's go butterfly guard. If he's got sticky feet under the knees, you know, he's following. You could be in danger here. Okay, so let's try this. Let's dive one arm in. Okay, and then I'm gonna walk it up as much as I can, then I straighten. So a pull and a push is jiu-jitsu, or a pull and push and a block. That's principle of jiu-jitsu, right? So we're gonna block. It seems like suicide. Like, why would I do this? But you're not really in a triangle danger because this is underneath my knee. I'm coming under, I'm walking up, I take the slack out. Doesn't have to be crazy pressure, but you know, I'm extending. I free by straightening. And then I'm gonna go to a two-on-one position with my legs. So I'm here, and then I gather, two-on-one. I'm gonna grab the belt. Then I find my little nook, and then I come through, and I'm in no danger here. Now, there is a slight chance.
Anchoring the belt, it's so good. You can really drive all your weight into him. Obviously, I don't want to do that, but there's security in this position. You know, beginners, they don't want to be anywhere near here because it looks like a triangle, but don't worry about that. Anchor, pull. As you do your back step, boom, you're gonna be pulling up on this really hard. That's your counterbalance. And then we come into position, okay? So, we got a butterfly guard. I'm gonna dive one arm through, walk up a little bit, go to a two-on-one position. I can also sprawl, kill that knee. Walk around. Clear it. Okay, now. There is a reverse triangle he could do here. Push my head, bam. But don't worry about that. You know, if he tries, you just posture a little. You can block with your elbow, block with your hand, whatever you need, okay? Don't worry about that. What you want to focus on is being courageous about this. Kill it, 2-on-1. Sprawl it out if you want to. I'm anchored. Pressure. Boop. Okay? Let's make that a little bit lower, a little bit tighter. 1, 2, 3.